welcome to ABC Interactive English. I'm Mike.
I'm Rainbow.
And thanks for joining us for a look at a very interesting topic that we will be learning more about in this month's A Window on the World unit. And that topic is animal rights. The idea that animals, just like people, have certain rights that should always be respected and, if it's necessary, they should also be protected by the law.
Right. As most of you know, I'm sure, people have rights. For example, the right to life, the right to be safe, the right to not be owned by another person as a slave, and the right to fair treatment by the police, the courts, and the law. Now, these are just a few examples of some of the basic human rights thatMost countries in the world agree that people should have.
Now, of course, some countries don't always agree with all of this. Mm-hmm. They might treat their people not as fairly as we would like, but the good news is that more and more countries and people around the world agree that human rights are important and certain rights should always be respected. But, and here's the interesting part for today, what about animals?Sure, animals aren't people. We're different. But animals are other living things on this planet. Just because humans might be smarter or more advanced or use cell phones, does that mean that only humans should have rights and animals shouldn't? Or should we try to show animals the same respect and give them the same protections that we give to people?It's a really interesting question, and it's also one that people often have very different opinions on.
So, over the next 3 days, we will be reading both a dialogue and an article that looks at the idea of international animal rights. And we'll also be hearing about some of the different things that people think about this difficult but important topic.It should be pretty interesting.
I think it will definitely be interesting. And don't worry, it's okay to have different opinions on this idea, but it's also important to talk about it with people you might not agree with and to have those difficult conversations with respect for each other. Mm-hmm. All right, before we begin reading our article for part one, which will be a short dialogue, let's check out the new vocabulary that we will be seeing today.
同学们听过 International Animal Rights Day 世界动物权日吗？我们今天的男女主角正要参加这个节日的活动。我们先来看几个单字。第一个单字 right 权利是个名词，一般我们会用复数 rights， 比方说人权 human rights， 而动物权则是 animal rights。The UN values human rights. The UN values human rights. 联合国非常重视人权。第二个单字 hold 有两个意思。第一个是捧，第二个是举行，是个动词。它的三态是 hold, held, held。比方说 hold a flower 是拿着捧着一朵花或是一束花。He held a flower in his hand for her. He held a flower in his hand for her. 他在手上拿了一朵花送给她。Hold a meeting 则是举办一个会议。We will hold an annual meeting in October. We will hold an annual meeting in October.我们在十月将举办年度会议。第三个单字 public 大众是个名词，我们可以用 the public 表示民众。 The media's job is to educate the public. The media's job is to educate the public. 媒体的工作是教育民众。最后一个单字 stomach 胃肚子是个名词。Avoid spicy food when your stomach hurts. Avoid spicy food when your stomach hurts. 肚子痛时避免吃辣。好了，我们现在看完单字例句，一起来看课文吧。
Brigitte and Richard are at an International Animal Rights Day event. Excuse me, why are all of you holding dead animals in your hands?
Last year, people killed over 150 billion animals just for food. We're just showing the public some of them.
What do you want people to get from that?
We want everyone to see that animals have rights too.
Explanation 1.
Okay, so the title of the article is a bit long, but here goes. The title is International Animal Rights Day. Animals have rights too. Phew, that's a mouthful of a title. And as we begin reading the dialogue, we can see that it begins by setting the scene of what's going on. We read, Brigitte and Richard are at an International Animal Rights Day event. Okay, so this is something that has been organized so that people who believe in animal rights can come together to talk about and share their opinions. And for people who don't know much about the whole idea of animal rights, well, they can come down to the event to learn more.
That's right. 我们在这边加几个补充单字。第一个是 international, 国际的。后面可以加名词，像是 international school, 国际学校。Event, 活动，通常是指正式举办的活动。比方说我们现在谈到的 International Animal Rights Day event, 就是正式的活动。And it's our character named Richard who begins the dialogue. He seems to be a visitor to the event, and he's just seen something quite unusual. He says to Brigitte, Excuse me, why are all of you holding dead animals in your hands? Oh my goodness, I guess Brigitte and some other people are holding the bodies of dead animals. Ew, okay, that's not something that you would see every day.
No, and I'm glad about that.
Yeah,
it also sounds like something that might not be too safe as well.
Yeah.
I hope they remember to wash their hands afterwards. Anyway, before we read on, we have to pause because the first sentence of the dialogue also has today's first grammar point in it. So let's learn more about that and then we can come back to read on.
大家好，我是 Daphne。今天的第一则文法是 Excuse me， 意思是请问一下，是一句祈使句，用原形动词 excuse 开头，意思是原谅，后方用 me 我当受词。Excuse me 字面意思就是原谅我，用于要叨扰他人之前，用来表示请问一下、抱歉、不好意思、借过。例如 ，Excuse me。I have to leave now. 抱歉，我必须离开了。
So, Brigitte and some of the people at an animal rights event are holding some dead animals
Ew,
in their hands.
Yuck.
Richard, a visitor to the event, wants to know why they are doing this. Back in our dialogue, Brigitte tells Richard, Last year, people killed over 150 billion animals just for food.And then she adds, we're just showing the public some of them. Okay. So they are probably holding some chickens or something like that. Animals that people would buy at a market to eat, for example. And sure, that number is quite shocking.
Yeah.
150 billion animals, like chickens, pigs, and cows, are killed every year so that people can have some of their favorite foods.When you see a big number like that, it can really hit home.
And that's exactly the effect that Brigitte and her friends are going for, to sort of shock people into thinking about this eating animals in a new way. But Richard, it seems, doesn't really understand what they're doing. So he says to Brigitte, what do you want people to get from that?He's asking Brigitte, what lesson or message are you trying to send people? What are you teaching by doing this?
And so Brigitte tells him, we want everyone to see that animals have rights too. I guess she feels that if they just stood on the street telling people about animal rights and handing out small leaflets with information, it wouldn't have the same shocking effect.As standing there holding dead animals. People might just walk by and not notice or look or pay attention. I can see her point. We do often ignore things until something happens to really force us to look.
Oh, that's true. 人类去年杀害超过1500亿只动物为食，因此活动里面人们手里捧着动物的尸体是为了让大家知道动物也是有权利的。可能他们觉得这样比较有传单，比传单更有效果，人们才不会忽略。Billion 是十亿的意思，而 leaflet 就是传单 ，ignore 就是忽视。Well, we are off to an interesting start, that's for sure. But let's take a quick break here to look at the second half of today's dialogue.
What do you mean?
Those animals had a right to live happy lives. They didn't have to die for our stomachs.
Of course they did.We need meat to live.
We can live on just fruits and vegetables.
Explanation 2.
So, Richard is talking with Brigitte, an animal rights supporter, about this idea that animals have rights just like people do, and so we shouldn't kill billions of them every year just for food.Brigitte thinks we should respect animals like we respect people.
Richard was probably shocked to see Brigitte holding the dead bodies of some of these animals, though, and now he's having a bit of trouble understanding her message. He says to her, "What do you mean?" He wants to know exactly what Brigitte means when she says that animals have the same rights as people.
And so Brigitte explains her ideas a little bit more. She tells Richard, these animals had a right to live happy lives. They didn't have to die for our stomachs. And remember, here she's talking about farm animals like chickens, pigs, and cows. Why do we just think of these animals, and they are living things, remember, just like us, but why do we just think of these kinds of animals in the same way that we think about any other thing that we buy? Even though it's a chicken, for example, shouldn't we treat it with a bit more respect?
But for Richard, a chicken may be an animal,But he seems to think that farm animals are raised to be food for us, so they're not really in the same category as pets or wild animals that we might protect. Farm animals are supposed to be food, so he doesn't think that it's so terrible that these animals were killed to feed people. He says, of course they did. We need meat to live. Humans are in that group of animals that need both meat and fruit and vegetables to live, right? So for Richard, this isn't really a question of what is right or wrong, but it's a question of nature. That's how we're made.
But Brigitte thinks that we can still make choices for ourselves, and really, we don't need meat to live. We can choose to just eat other things.As we reach the end of the dialogue, Brigitte tells Richard, we can live on just fruits and vegetables. Sure, lots of people do. They are called vegetarians, and there are millions and millions of them out there living perfectly happy and healthy lives while at the same time not hurting animals to get their next meal. Well, we told you this would be interesting and maybe a bit difficult. And it's also okay to sort of agree with both Richard and Brigitte. They both are making fairly good points.
Right. Brigitte 是动物权利的支持者，同时也是素食者。她觉得人类可以不用吃肉，只吃蔬菜水果为生。Supporter 就是支持者 ,Vegetarian 是素食者。Alright, well that's about all the time that we have for now, but before we say goodbye, let's look at the final grammar point that was used in the last sentence of that dialogue.
第二则文法是 live on something, 意思是以某食物为生。Live 是不及物动词，意思是过活。On 是介系词，意思是凭靠。例如 the athlete lives on energy bars.这位运动员靠营养棒为生。
Okay, folks, we are officially out of time for today. Thanks for joining us, and we will see you back here tomorrow when we will be reading the first of our two articles about International Animal Rights Day. We hope that you can come back to join us for that. Until then, be well, take care of each other, and bye-bye.
International Animal Rights Day. Animals have rights too. Brigitte and Richard are at an International Animal Rights Day event. Excuse me, why are all of you holding dead animals in your hands?
Last year, people killed over 150 billion animals just for food. We're just showing the public some of them.
What do you want people to get from that?
We want everyone to see that animals have rights too.
What do you mean?
Those animals had a right to live happy lives. They didn't have to die for our stomachs.
Of course they did. We need meat to live.
We can live on just fruits and vegetables.
各位同学大家好，我是建安老师。我们今天带大家看一下照片描述题当中单人常见动作的什么小动作 ，OK， 大 B 小 B， 一般 B 的小 B，All right， 小动作，小动作呢就不是那种搬东西啦，然后呢要上车上船这种哦，它是什么？就比如说吃东西 ，eating，OK，having，OK，they、okay? okay? are having a meal，they are eating a meal，OK，、okay? 喝东西，好像看到杯子在那边喝的样子 ，OK， drinking， 如果呢这个杯子放在那边 ，OK， 杯子放在那边里面有饮料，但是他们没有拿起来这个样子。drink 就不行，再来伸手去拿，这个还蛮常出现的 ，reaching for 就是伸手去拿东西，再来 raising his her 或者 their hands， OK， 举手，这个也很常见哦，比如说 the students， the people are raising their hands， 再来拿东西给 handling， all right， handle 的用法呢，比如说 the man is handling the woman some paper， OK， 这男生呢把一些文件给这个女生哦， handle aB, OK， 再来 pointing at 指着 ，OK， 手指着哪个东西 pointing at， 再来看东西，这也是小动作。那看的话，同义词非常的多，这些都是非常高频的、哦。第一个 looking at 看着 ，All right， watching 也是看，但是 A 跟 B 这 looking at 跟 watching 的差别在于说 looking at 是盯着看哈、哦，就是比较仔细的瞧，但是 watch 的话就是看看着会动的东西、哦、而不是凝视了。再来 checking 检查 ，viewing 也是看 ，examining 跟 checking 它的意思是一样的，都是检查。All right， 小动作还有哪一些呢？我们看到右手边这里哦，说话 speaking talking to addressing presenting， All right， 这些都是说。All right。所以呢要特别注意一下不能只会 speaking OK talking to addressing presenting 这些同义词的代换非常的重要再来 reading 阅读 writing filling out 他正在填写或正在写东西的样子再来归档、哦、这个也蛮常出现的叫 sorting papers 他正在 sort 其实就是分类了他把这些文件呢把它给分类好 sorting papers 再来呢Filing 归档也是这个字哦 ，filing 它是从 file f i l e 这个字来的 ，filing paper， 那也可以用 separating papers 啊、哦，就把这些文件把它分开来，分门别类把它给整理好。再来付款 paying for OK 付款就再来放东西 placing putting laying 放什么东西在什么桌面上啦、啊，在哪里哦，这个也还蛮常见的。折 folding。最后 assembling 哦，它正在组合东西、组装东西，这个也是 OK。好，再来我们看一下这个一般的动作，也就是说比较笼统的动作，这些其实很重要。为什么呢？因为它是比较是概括性的意思哦。比如说 using， 为什么 using 很重要呢？因为 using 它可能是用的一个设备是很复杂的。All right， 比如说它在用这个显微镜，那你就突然忘记啊，显微镜它的是英文是什么？啊、microscope 但是你忘记了结果呢他讲出来说 OK、the people are using some equipment OK 人类、哦、这些人呢他在使用一些设备、啊、some equipment 他就用 some equipment 去代替过了所以 use 就是一个非常笼统的动作再来 working 比如说他在做简报他在打字或者是呢他在这个写文件看起来就是在工作的样子 OK 或者是在用电脑等等不管The man is working, 这样可不可以？ 可以啊、哦、所以呢这个就是概括性的动作，在图片描述体概括性的动作其实还蛮常出现的，所以这边要特别注意一下哦。再来做东西 make， 我们可以制造做东西的时候 make coffee 泡咖啡， make cookie 变成是烘焙饼干了、哦、所以呢这边 make 它也是一个概括性的动作。那只要在商店看起来像在购物的样子、哦、就是买东西啦， shopping， shopping for something， 这个很重要。再来呢开关、哦、turn on turn off， 这些都是概括性的动作，因为你不知道它是在开什么关什么嘛，对不对？所以呢它也不会特别的讲出来、就是 turning off、turning on 等等的。再来进入某个比如说房间也好或者大楼，这些都是 entering， 那有 enter 就有离开咯， leaving。 那打招呼这个也是一个概括性的动作，两个人、哦、或者是 一群人他们在 hi 之类的那个样子、哦、就是打招呼 greeting。 OK、哦、所以呢这些动作大家都要非常的熟、哦、就是小动作也好、哦、或者是呢这些一般的概括性的动作大家都要非常的熟、哦、就是要熟得不得了，看到的时候听到的时候呢就很自然就会写了。以上是我们今天的课程内容，我们下部影片见，拜拜。
Hello， 大家好，我是 Hanny， 欢迎收看我们一分钟的单元。在这一分钟的时间里面，我们要复习四个单字，还会造句练习。同学们，您都准备好了没？好，一分钟计时开始。第一个单字呢，是指权利，这字叫做 right。Right， 没错，就是右边的那个字 Right， 它可以指权利，像 human rights 就可以表达人权。 Most women didn't have the right to vote in the past， 在过去啊，大多数的女性都没有投票权。第二单字呢，它可以用来表达捧或是托，像你抱着不是把某个东西这样捧着吗？或者是它可以表达举行的意思，这个字就是 hold。Hold 动词三态是 hold held held， 我们分别用这两个意思来造句。 OK， 捧着拖着，我们可以说 Melissa is holding a puppy in her arms， Melissa 手里抱着一只小狗狗。那么用举行来造句， Their wedding will be held in December， 他们的婚礼将于十二月举行。第三单字它可以指大众或是民众，这个字叫做 public， public 我们通常会用 the public 来表达。 The government has lost the public's trustThe government has lost the public's trust. 政府已经失去民众的信任了。好，第四单字是指胃。好，这一次哦 ，stomach 是胃，或是肚子的意思。I'm so hungry, my stomach is growling. 我超饿的，肚子正在咕噜咕噜叫。你可以用 growling 来表达肚子咕噜咕噜叫。好啦，不管怎么样，我们虽然没有成功，但是还是有复习完这些单字了。那我们下次继续一起加油咯，我们下次见，拜拜。
See you next time. Baby, 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 baby.